And I'm going about complaining to the sinners and everyone else. I know who I am. I'm the creation of the Lord.
South Australians are caught in the middle of a bikey war.
I think I heard about like four pops. It's like a pop, 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 then a pop.
Fireworks. That's it, like bang, bang.
Tensions between gangs are reaching boiling point, made more volatile by struggles for power within those groups.
These people have no regard for the law, and despite the efforts we put into investigating these offences, they will continue to take matters into their own hands.
2011 closed with three shootings in public areas in 3 days. First, the leader of the local Comancheros chapter was shot in the leg in an ambush attack in the middle of suburbia.
22-year-old Giovanni was gunned down in an ambush in January last year. Focarelli was also shot in what was the sixth time his enemies had tried to kill him and failed.
As Adelaide's now deadly gang war once again spilled into the streets, so too did the grief. Hazard lights flash on Prospect Road, a lifeless Giovanni Focarelli slumped in the front passenger seat of the WA-plated Ford sedan.
His head.
Loved ones gathered too at the Royal Adelaide Hospital to check on his notorious gangster father, Vince Focarelli, who survived despite four gunshot wounds. Armed police frisked patients and visitors and turned some away, among the first to see the surviving gang leader, his lawyer.
I'm sorry, I can't add anything further.
Vince Focarelli seen here a fortnight ago with Giovanni, the father last night surviving a fourth assassination attempt but losing his son. Their family's shock soon turning to anger.
Buzz off, man.
Respect. That's all we're asking. Do your photos later.
A security camera on Prospect Road captured Vince Focarelli's desperate dash for help, his dying son next to him. Moments later, he hailed a police patrol. The area locked down.
Very scary. My partner finishes 11 o'clock every night and has to walk down the street. And I don't want no shootings and, you know, it's a nice quiet area. It was.
A bloody trail shows the desperation of a marked man running from an ambush. Vince Focarelli smashed his way into a home with a bullet still lodged in his thigh.
He shouted to ask me to open the door. I tried to hold the door and I just rang to the police. I smashed that window and came inside.
The Comancheros president's pleas for help went door to door along Stebbins Heath Road.
Got a towel, wrapped his leg, trying to stop the bleeding. But then when I noticed that the people that were after him were still hanging around the area, I'd gone back inside and left him out the front.
An injured Focarelli frantically scaled two fences into a young family's backyard where police eventually found him.
I got three little girls inside, so my priority was to make sure that they were safe.
The 37-year-old was shot fleeing a late night meeting.
I think I heard about like four pops. It's like a pop, 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 then a pop.
Focarelli arrived with a friend. They became separated when the altercation turned deadly.
It appears the gunman was well prepared. Witnesses saw a motorcycle rider waiting up the road on a brand new Japanese-style sports bike. The gunman jumped on the back and the pair raced off.
Hospital security on high alert as Comancheros members keep a bedside vigil at the Royal Adelaide. He's previously been the target of a botched car bombing, a fire bombing on his home, and another shooting attempt at a supermarket, all linked to a long-running feud with the Hells Angels.
If it is rival gang related, there's obviously the opportunity there for some sort of retribution.
Blood was the only evidence found at the scene.
Regardless of who the victims are, we will mount a very considerable investigation to find the persons responsible for this incident.
Police traced the shooting scene to Flame Avenue in Dry Creek.
Just like pop, 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 pop.
I heard about three or four, and then the car sped off.
Go out in the middle of nowhere and knock each other off. But don't be doing it in our streets.
Police are again investigating the internal feud within the Comancheros, but Focarelli's lawyer claims he and his son were no longer in the gang. Regardless, detectives fear reprisals.
Nonetheless, we'll try to do what we can to talk some sense in these people and prevent anyone else from getting injured.
Hope for the sake of the community and
Adelaide that nothing else happens.
The Assistant Commissioner does admit his officers are losing the fight to keep illegal weapons off the streets.
Unfortunately, there are a lot out there, and as often as we take them out, they're sourcing other illegal firearms.
The state's specialist bikie gang task force has been boosted with extra detectives to investigate the recent shootings and try to head off another shootout. Police claim his gang is imploding, with a shootout in an inner city cafe, the result of a dispute between Comanchero members.
Very lucky for when you look at the traffic that comes in and out of our busy venue, that no one was seriously hurt.
The former head of the Comancheros and the New Boys Street Gang was arrested in his hospital bed soon after an ambush in which he was shot and his son was killed. The former Comancheros boss was subsequently jailed for drug offences relating to that night. He only visited his murdered son Giovanni's grave for the first time last Wednesday, a day after being released from prison, where he spent the past 15 months for gun and drug crimes. And today, his first hours of freedom were spent in sombre prayer at a Woodville mosque. A short time later, he re-emerged to visit his son's grave for the first time. After finally finding where he was buried, Foccarelli broke down and wept. No longer a prisoner, but Vincenzo Foccarelli's homecoming was marred by sorrow.
How does it feel to be a free man?
Allahu Akbar.
Is it a bit bittersweet?
His response in Arabic, meaning God is greatest, it comes as he now plans a funeral, just 2 hours before the gangland figure was released from Yatla yesterday afternoon. His father Giuseppe passed away in hospital. The flamboyant and loyal grandfather died from bleeding on the brain after battling an aggressive cancer. It's the second sad chapter Foccarelli missed during his 14 months in jail. Burying a father to whom he never got to say goodbye. Vince Foccarelli overcome as his father Giuseppe is laid to rest. The 78-year-old died last Tuesday, just 2 hours before the former gang leader was released on parole. The flamboyant, self-taught artist, renowned in Italy, had always shown strong support for his son. Today, dozens of mourners flocked to a Catholic Paynim church, then Enfield burial ground, to pay their respects, as a discreet but visible police presence watched on. Flanked by family, Vince Foccarelli broke down several times during the ceremonies in a week that's been full of grief.
Out of the underworld and into the kitchen, it's Vince Foccarelli as you've never seen him before.
I feel fantastic, I feel great, I feel healthy. I feel strong, mind, mentally and spiritually.
He says his new restaurant in Carrington Street is doing a roaring trade.
It's halal, organic and vegan, so we cater for Muslims and non-Muslims here, which is good.
It's a far cry from his violent past. As leader of the Comancheros, Foccarelli survived 6 attempts on his life, one that killed his son Giovanni in 2012.
We miss Johnny very dearly. He's always in our thoughts. We think about and talk about him daily.
He's been shot in the leg and survived a bombing attempt that killed 2 Hells Angels associates. Once a marked man, now he says he's a changed one.
I've completely distanced myself in all aspects of that life. I played my part and also I received in return as much. I'm a human being. Regardless of whatever I have done in the past, everyone makes mistakes.
And he credits religion with his dramatic transformation.
I think Islam has played, if not, it has played a big factor in my change.
Abdul Salam. Salam alaikum.
Alhamdulillah.
Brother, now that's an authentic Italian meal. What's the story? Lafik. New restaurant. Adelaide's all talking about it. Tell us a little bit about it.
Alhamdulillah, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah, we started off by talking at home in our kitchen, my wife and I, you know, and we come to an understanding that the brothers and sisters haven't got the luxury that everyone else has, where they can walk out the house and go to any cafe, restaurants, and pick out their food, whether it's Italian cuisine, French, Japanese and whatnot. So, you know, we got thinking and we said, look, we want to open up a small cafe. Why don't we do it properly? Why don't we help the community of the Muslims and do something, you know, different.
Halal?
Yeah, of course. Yes. It's halal, organic and vegan. So we cater for Muslims and non-Muslims here, which is good. And so what we said, look, I'm Italian. So I just want to say that all praise and glory be to Allah, because without Allah, no atom moves without the grace of God. And we want to say, you know, praise Allah for giving us this. We want to make sure that all the barakah and the blessing that we're getting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we want to follow in accordance to the five pillars of Islam, which one of them is zakat, you know. And as Muslims, it's our responsibility to give, especially on the day of Ramadan, where we can learn to be humble and pious and absorb all the kindness and all the love that is in and around the world. At the moment, we get in a bad run with Islam. I won't bring the politics side of things, but when they walk in here, the non-Muslims, they give us a great review because they get the real taste of Islam. Starts from us and the barakah from Allah. Also with Ramadan, we're trying to give whatever we sell, there'll be a portion of a percentage of that profit that goes to Human Appeal, and we want to contribute that in the best way possible, inshallah. What we've done is inshallah they're on their way. We've been confirmed that we've got some ajwa dates coming from Medina. Also when you walk into this place, we'll give everybody a date. And we want to do the sunnah with the soup, and so people can, the brothers and sisters can break fast.
Very good.
And then what we've done, we've established three main dishes, lamb, camel, and the chicken, with a variety of rice and couscous and stuff like that and salads. So everyone gets the opportunity to break fast. Because when you come in here, when you order here, you wait 45 minutes, 40 minutes, half an hour sometimes, a little bit because of restaurant with the busyness that gets through. But in regards to Ramadan, there's two special things. You don't have to wait for your meal. We'll be ready for you, including to all the taxi drivers out there that can't stop and break fast on Ramadan. Please feel free to come past Lafik Cucinas on the days that we break fast. That we'll have a package for you in a bag for you to go if you're on work schedules, inshallah. And also with the homeless, if you don't mind, if I can put this out to everyone. We were doing a homeless soup kitchen at the back. We have homeless at the back, inshallah, every Saturday. And we conflicted with the Christian church. So what we did, we had a sit down with a committee. And we sat down and we spoke in regards to the best opportunity. So because they do Saturdays and other places do other days, we picked Tuesdays. And we're in talks with Alex Hale, one of Dan's very close friends, who's very tight with the homeless around here. So Tuesdays, to all the homeless out there, homeless people, come to 94 Carrington Street, Lafik Cucina, around about 7:30 at the back of our shop, and come and get something warm, inshallah.
Now hold on a second, are you telling me that this fine dining restaurant, that I can pretty much say it's a five-star restaurant, also caters for the homeless?
Inshallah, yes brother.
Now that's definitely a barakah that we want to share with everybody else. Yeah. What we say, this is a special place. We're not joking about it. This is serious. Jazakallah khair. Everyone here that's getting looked after. We've got the homeless here at the back. On Tuesdays, they're getting looked after. During Ramadan, they're contributing towards the needy overseas. So, all brothers and sisters that are struggling, these guys are contributing into it. For the ones that can't stop, that don't have time, these guys are doing them packs. So you can break your fast on the go without affecting your work.
Inshallah.
We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put barak in this place. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this Ramadan will be a blessed Ramadan for you and for the rest of the family that we have here. I honestly want to say from myself and the community, may Allah reward you, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless it and to continue giving us people like yourself.
Jazakallah. Okay, brother. Okay.
And he credits religion with his dramatic transformation.
I think Islam has played, if not, it has played a big factor in my change.
Out of the underworld and into the kitchen, it's Vince Foccarelli as you've never seen him before.
I feel fantastic, I feel great, I feel healthy, I feel strong, mind, mentally and spiritually.
He says his new restaurant in Carrington Street is doing a roaring trade.
It's halal, organic and vegan, so we cater for Muslims and non-Muslims here, which is good.
It's a far cry from his violent past. As leader of the Comancheros, Foccarelli survived six attempts on his life, one that killed his son Giovanni in 2012.
We miss Johnny very dearly. He's always in our thoughts. We think about and talk about him daily.
He's been shot in the leg and survived a bombing attempt that killed two Hells Angels associates. Once a marked man, now he says he's a changed one.
I've completely distanced myself in all aspects of that life.
There are many that ask, what do Muslims recite in their five daily prayer? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
And I've been about the companions and the servant and everyone else. I know who I am. I'm the creation of Allah.